there is a discussion in the field about whether Alzheimer's disease should be defined by the clinical phenotype of dementia, or whether we should stick to the heart diagnosis, the presence of amyloid tangles and neuronal tangles and amyloid plaques, which is the original definition basically of Alzheimer's disease by Alois Alzheimer. And so up to the last years, we could only make a diagnosis of certainty when the patient died and you did pathology, neuropathology of the brain. At the moment, there are other ways to know whether somebody has amyloid plaques or neuronal tangles. You can use PET scans, or you can use all kinds of fluid diagnostics, including nowadays blood measurements. And so a large group of scientists would say we should define Alzheimer's disease not by its clinical phenotype, but by the fact that the blood biomarkers and the PET scans of these patients are changed. This has huge implications because all of a sudden we will have many more patients with Alzheimer's disease than before. And of course, the clinicians, the people who are really focused on the practice, say, yeah, but it has no sense to define somebody with Alzheimer's disease as long as there is no dementia. And so at the moment, the idea is that we should use this for research purposes, but also for clinical trials. Because if you define it only when dementia is present, then you're probably too late with your therapies. And so, and that's basically debate going on. So I will argue that we should move into the biological definition of the disease, even in clinical practice, and consider patients which are apparently normal, at least with the criteria we use now, still when they have these lesions, I would say they are on their way to full dementia.